Everyone has a plan until they get punched in the face. We are facing all these different punches in our life. And they are different. They could be small, big, light, or heavy. And they come from different sources, probably from your study, your exams, for instance, or from your work, from your business, or from your friends and family. And we overcome one and the other one's coming, and we just don't know when it will be. As an international student, came to this country to pursue my dream 11 years ago. I indeed got a lot of these punches every single day. And all these punches that I will be able to overcome one by one by one by one. Until one day that I think this is something that I received the biggest punches in my life. And I wasn't able to really handle it because I'm not ready for it. It punched me and I thought I would never be able to stand up again. 1st of June is a special day. And today we gather together for the TEDx event. And even this is more special for me and my family because it was supposed to be my first daughter's 4-year-old birthday. But it didn't turn out to be the plan. She arrived 3 months earlier. At 26 weeks and weight 494 grand. And that is tiny as it is, 2 feet building together. And she was the smallest in the hospital. And I will never forget the day that she was born. After I settled my wife in her ward, and I was looking at a little gift. It's there, a flower and a pink bear. That was a gift that for us to celebrate the new member of our family. But where is the new member? And I was looking at this and suddenly I heard of some baby crying and I raised my head. I looked around. No, that's not my baby. It's someone else next door. And I would start to wonder, where is my baby? And I asked the nurse and she told me she is in the intensive care. And I asked, she is still alive. And the nurse said, do you want to visit her? And I hesitated. I was not sure. And that was an answer from a father. And very, very nervous about the first meeting of his baby. I struggled and I eventually convinced myself to go downstairs to go to the intensive care. When I entered the room, and that's a long corridor, and I walk and I think, and there's so many feelings, and I heard the sounds of the monitors, the equipment, and the baby crying. And all coming through me. And I felt like that's the longest corridor I have ever walked in my life. She was in the end of the corridor where the most severe patient stayed. And I was look outside of the room and look in there. I took a very, very deep breath. I stepped forward. And this is what I saw. And that thing is called incubator. It's very high tech. And with all this life supporting equipment and help you breathe and help you with the things, the nutrition that you need and to simulate just like the mommy's tummy. And I look in there, I wasn't sure that was my baby. She's in there, so close, but so far. I took another step forward. And that was foggy because of the heating. And I looked inside. I couldn't stay there for another second. It's wrapped by bubble paper. And with all the needles and tubes, I ran her. And she was so pink, so tiny, so fragile. I felt again, she's so close, but again, so far away because I couldn't even touch her as a father. And I'm staring in through the incubator for another few minutes. And what I was supposed to do is I have all these dreams. I want you to take out there for a walk. Because I look through the window, it's blue sky, clear weather. That's why I came to this country. And I was not able to walk you out there forever. And since so difficult, and I started to cry. And suddenly, this one hand putting on my shoulder. And I realized it's a nurse. And I would start to wipe my tears because I wouldn't want people to see that. And she said, oh, it's okay. It is hard. You can cry. You have the right to cry. And I share a lot of things with her. I say, I regretted so many things in the past we couldn't be able to do. Maybe if I do this, maybe it will be a different outcome. And I worry about the future because that is a completely change of plan. I never expected. And what happened next? And she just asked me one question. What is the time now? And I look at my watch. I say 5 p.m. And she said, there's still some time today. Do something for her. Do something for you to see her tomorrow. But don't think about tomorrow. Wow. At that moment, just these simple words that fill my broken heart. And I ran out with a thank you. And I ran back to the ward. And I did one thing for her. that's the form I feel, with a lot of tears. It's a really slow process. When I finish, I sign it, and I seal it, and I drop it into the postbox. And the moment I feel I dropped that letter, and I was so proud of myself because I did it. And that's the most important letter I think I will ever send in my life. And I was empowered through that moment. I did it. One thing for her. What next? And I ran back to the room to learn how to look after her. And I went back to work 5 days after that, full time, because it was needed. And people were surprised how we'd be able to do it. And there are so many things that we have to learn, but that's okay. I learned how to look after her in the incubator, very new. I need to learn how to cuddle her in a very special way. And we need to learn how to bath her because all the equipment and feed her, training the sucking skills, and talk to her every day to train her brain. So every single day, one step at a time, and I applied this. Now, this is what I can do. Now, this is what I can do for you. And after 183 days in the intensive care, we made it. We went home and was so happy. But again, the punches all still coming because we went home with oxygens and feeding tubes. It's very hard to handle it, and there's new things to pick up. As her, the little beautiful warrior, that I look at her to grow every day. And we still apply. Now, this is what I can do for her. And another 228 days, she removed all this supporting equipment. It's a normal girl. But I always reflect, especially today, what if I was just focusing on the past and regretting that something that I could have done better to avoid happening, to avoid these punches? And what if I was just dreaming about a future and worrying that the things that I cannot achieve anymore? What if I didn't just focus on the moment of now and did something for her every day? We wouldn't be able to see her smile anymore. I think for all of you here, you might have encountered a lot of punches recently about your study, about your work, about your business, about someone that you don't like in your life. And all these punches arrive at the time that you are not ready. And we are facing all these punches in our life, every day, every moment. But if you would like to do something, we still have some time today. Thank you.